Morning all, hope everybody doing good. In our last video we discussed about the magnetic circuits. In that one we discussed the different types of couplings, that is electrical and the magnetic couplings, okay, that is series aiding, parallel aid, series aiding, series opposing, and then without the physical contact we discussed. Okay, today I'm going to explain about the problems which are related to these two things. Okay, this is my presentation for that one. The first problem given is the total inductance of the two coils connected in a series cumulatively means aiding is 1.6, and the connected differentially means opposing is 0.4 henry. The self inductance of coil, okay, let us assume one coil is 0.6 henry. Calculate the mutual inductance and the coefficient of coupling. Our objective is to find out the two things. One is mutual inductance, another one is coefficient of coupling, that is K value. Okay. So the given data is, for a series aiding circuit, we know that the formula for the series aiding is L1 plus L2 plus 2M equals to, the given value as 1.6. So I am writing L1 plus L2 plus 2M equals to 1.6. And series opposing means the differential is 0.4. L1 plus L2 minus 2M is equals to 0.4. So this is what they given. And the inductance of one coil they given as 0.6. That is L1 value they given as 0.6. Okay. So if I subtract both things, L1 plus L2 plus 2M minus L1 plus L2 minus 2M. So these two will get cancelled. This one minus minus will get plus. So the 4M value is 1.2. Okay. So because of subtraction, we will get 1.2. From that one, we know the M value as 0.3, because if I send 4 in this side, we will get a 0.3. Okay. As they given that L1 value is 0.6. If I substitute in this equation, L1 value is a 0.6, L2 we don't know, M value is 0.3, we will get L2 value as 0.4 henry. Okay. So we know the values of L1, L2 and M values. Okay. As we know that the inductance, the mutual inductance M equals to K root L1 and L2. From that one, the coefficient of coupling K equals to M by root L1, L2. We know the both the values. If you substitute those values, we'll get the K value as 0.612. This is the one kind of problem. They give the values, we find out. In some cases, they will give the L1 and L2 values. Okay, and then whether they say whether is seriously aiding or seriously opposing, we have to find out these formulas. Then we have to find the coefficient of coupling. Other than that, we don't have that many kind of problems for this one. Okay. Another one is magnetically coupled, means two coils doesn't have any physical contact. Okay. So this is our problem. In this problem, we have one source, two at an angle 0 volts, supplying the for a coil 1, and we have a mutual inductance of J3 ohm between the coil 1 and coil 2. Okay. So how you will write a coil 1 equation, KVL equation? I am using the KVL to solve the, to find the phasor currents I1 and I2. Okay. So there are two loops, the loop currents I1 and I2 I am considering. Okay. So in the first case, the loop 1 current enters at the dotted side, but the loop 2 is in opposite side. Okay. So this is what we have to remember while writing the KVL equation. Why? Because as we learned in the dot convention, if the both currents entered are lived in the same direction, the same sign has to consider for the mutual inductance. Okay, if both are differs, we have to take the opposite sign of self inductance. Okay, so how we are going to write the first one is the first KVL equation. -12 means the supply voltage I am considering -12 plus, I am taking positive sign for the total I1 current, that is minus J4 and plus J5. So this is the total reactance. Okay. Total reactance in coil, loop 1 is J5 minus J4. Okay. So that is what I am considering. The sign is positive. Okay. How I am going to write the mutual? Mutual has to be coupled with 1 and 2. So the mutual inductance is J3. In the first case, I take, in the case of this one, I consider positive sign. current enters in opposite means I have to consider opposite sign, that is minus J3 and the current is I2. So simplifying that one, JI1 minus J3 I2 is given the 12. If I send 12 over there, so we'll get an equation 1. Okay. Equation 2, the total is 12 plus J6. So this is the total reactance. How we are considering total reactance? I am considering a positive sign. So what about the virtual inductance? We have to write opposite sign, that is minus J3 I1. Okay. If I am considering a loop 1, the mutual inductance is always the mutual inductance is always opposite current. If I am writing a loop 1 current, means the mutual inductance J3 has to write with I2. If I am writing a loop 2 current, means I have to consider mutual inductance J3 ohms with loop 1 current. Okay, that is what I am represented by simplifying these two equations. Okay, so we will get I1 value as in terms of I2. If I substitute this value, I will get the I2 value as 2.91 at an angle 14.04 degrees. Okay, so if I substitute in equation 2 or 3, we will get the I1 value as this one. Okay, these are all the two kinds of problems regularly asked in the examination point of view for a magnetic coupled circuits. Okay, hope you understood, guys. Have a nice day. Take care, guys.